Good morning, students. Now let us proceed. Chapter number 11, the dispersion of white light by prism. Yesterday already we have discussed about the refraction of the light through glass prism. So today we proceeded. Now you have seen the rainbow in rainy season. So there are spectacular colors in the rainbow. So here white light of the sun when passes through the droplets of the water, then it split and the band of seven colors on the other side we can see as a rainbow. So here first we go back to the refraction of light through prism and the inclined refracting surfaces of the glass prism. They shows the exciting phenomena. First of all, we perform one activity for understanding the dispersion of light. Here, activity number 11.2 in your textbook on page number 193. First of all, for this you have to take one cardboard, sheet of cardboard and make a small hole or narrow slit in it. So this is the cardboard and this is the hole or narrow slit in this cardboard to allow the ray of sunlight, right? Now allow the sunlight to fall on the narrow slit and this gives a narrow beam of white light which incident on the glass prism. Now take a glass prism and allow the light from the slit to fall on one of its faces as shown in the figure. Turn the prism slowly until the light that comes out of it appears on nearby screen. So what do you observe? You will find the beautiful band of seven colors and these seven colors you will find here, band of seven colors on the screen or other side. And the sequence of the color you can see, if you see from the base, that is violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red finally, right? Here this to remember easily the acronym of this VIBGYOR, V for violet, I for indigo, B for blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange and R for red. So remember easily and in sequence you have to remember the word VIBGYOR, that is acronym of this. So here these seven colors in sequence can be seen. Now what is the spectrum? The spectrum we see on other side. Spectrum means the band of seven colors is called the spectrum of light. Now here the white light when goes from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, then what happens? That it splits into seven constituent colors and that phenomenon is known as the dispersion of white light. So what is the definition of dispersion? The splitting of white light into its seven constituent colors is called dispersion. So two definitions, dispersion, then spectrum, then you have to remember the colors in order. So this is the dispersion of light, that it disperses into seven colors by the prism and different colors of light bend through different angles. So with respect to the incident ray, and they pass through when they pass through the prism, the red light that bends less while the least, while the violet bends most. In figure you can see, so the rays of each color emerge along different paths and become distinct. It is the band of distinct colors that we see in the spectrum and first time it was noticed by Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton noticed this phenomenon of glass prism and obtained the spectrum of sunlight. He tried to split the colors of spectrum of white light further by using another similar spectrum. He could not get any more colors. Then he placed a second identical prism to an inverted position with respect to the first prism, as now shown in the figure. Now if we keep two prisms means one is the inverted and another in this position. So here two prisms were kept in this way, and then when the white light that passes through the first prism, it split into seven colors. Now again these band of seven colors will enter to another prism. This is P1, prism 1, this is prism 2, P2. So again these colors, the seven colors, they recombine and we get again the white light back. So what do you understand from this activity? From this activity that you can understand that the white light is composed of seven constituent colors. So the structure of white light can be understood through the phenomenon of dispersion of light. And again these seven colors, they enter to another prism, then they recombine and again we get the white light back. So one prism that disperses and another prism that nullified its effect, and then recombine all the colors and we get white light back. So this was first noticed by the scientist Isaac Newton. Is it clear? So today you have to complete activity 11.2, and that is the dispersion of white light through the prism, the definition of dispersion, then spectrum, and these colors you have to remember in sequence. Otherwise you will not get the marks, and this is most important question, maybe ask for 3 marks. Okay.